Thank you. We know you're applauding for the jazz band. Thank you so much, jazz band. That's awesome. Thank you for being here for our 15th and final Prairie Gas Awards Challenge. We're so glad you're here. We'll get to that in a minute, but I know tonight is going to be an awesome show because when you have two guys our age squeeze into skinny pants, you know it's going to be an awesome show. Right, Bob?
You're just jealous because I make this look good. To some people. Ladies and gentlemen, we are glad that you are here for this final big time together where we celebrate the story making of film. We're glad for you participants this past year who had 48 hours to do this film challenge and overcame some challenges. We enjoyed watching the films as a committee, and I'm sure the judges did too. So tonight we are going to celebrate that. There'll be some cash prizes for different categories as we go. And we just welcome you to this final Prairie Grass Film Challenge. So it's great to have you here at campus. I know we have a lot of people joining on live stream, so welcome to those watching as well. Some of those are competitors also, but before we get started, Dr. Hoekstra has been here faithfully for the last 15 years, I guess you could say, but he is not able to be at this last one. He's out of town tonight. So we have a very good fill-in, though at the CCU conference, I did his job for him, just letting you know that. And we welcome Brandon Huseman. He's the Vice President of Enrollment and Marketing. Brandon, if you could come on up.
So I've been wondering for a little while how on earth I got this gig. And it finally occurred to me, I was actually an extra on the very first film challenge that we ever had, Prairie Grass Film Challenge. This was all the way 15 years ago. My cool older brother Aaron talked me into it. But tonight is going to be a night of stories. We're going to reminisce. We're going to celebrate. But before we get to that, I want to welcome up a very special guest, Janelle Volkers, the bride of Mark Volkers. Please welcome her, as well as the esteemed Vern Eekhoff, back and better than ever from California.
Thank you.
I would ask to say a few words about Mark, which I quickly said yes to. It was about 15 years ago when the first Prairie Grass happened that I really got to know Mark. And we had a team in that competition. And when you're making the very first one, you think, we got to make a film, got to make a film. Kind of like we got to get to our destination. And what we found out, and through the program that Mark helped create, it's not about the destination. It's about the journey getting there. And the journey is getting that script, getting your actors, putting the whole thing together, editing it, just thinking outside the box and being creative. And in behalf of all the people who have participated, we want to thank you, Mark, and give you this as a symbol of our appreciation.
Just a note for all of you, this is a custom art piece by Dort Emeritus Professor Jake Van Wyk, so you'll have to come up and take a look at that later on. So we're celebrating 15 years of content worth consuming. At Dort University, we are all about developing effective kingdom citizens. So the natural question I have tonight is it working? So let me tell you just a couple stories about the impact that the Prairie Grass Film Challenge has had on a generation of filmmakers and storytellers. I reached out to a couple this week, and here's what they had to say. Nathan Walter, longtime participant, now works in Sioux Falls. He said, I think what makes Prairie Grass so memorable is that it makes you do so many unexpected things in the name of film. And I'm not talking about staying up all night editing. That's expected, right? What's unexpected is locking yourself into a 6x6 room with a camera and a bag of Legos for 32 hours, uninterrupted, doing stop motion animation, all for the sake of film. What a wild ride. Or Danielle Rose. Danielle said that the Prairie Grass Film Challenge was something that I looked forward to every year after it launched. I started out as an actor, but then kept coming back as I learned more about writing, directing, and cinematography. Danielle was admitted, one of three that were admitted into the Master of Fine Arts program in directing at the esteemed Northwestern University. Or Piper Cruz. Piper said she competed in the very first one, and she's been judging for just over 8 years now, but it's always been something she's desired to be involved in. Perhaps you've seen her work on Prison Break, or God Friended Me, or You. She had this to say. She said, "I'll never forget how it felt that first year when we showed our film in a crowded BJ Hahn auditorium, and I heard the crowd roar when it was complete. To see the impact my stories could have on other people, it just confirmed that I wanted to make movies. And now I do. I make movies." The last one, my own brother, Aaron Huseman. He said he participated in and judged the Prairie Grass Film Challenge for years. But it wasn't until later that he really appreciated it, because each year he knew he was going to see a certain type and style of video. But to see the progression of that, year over year over year, getting better and better, just so impressive. And so collectively they said to Mark, to the committee, thank you for putting in your efforts year over year. It's a lot to manage, all the judges, all the teams, the premier event. But for many, this event was the jumpstart that they needed for their career. From their team alone, they now have someone who writes national television shows, one who develops packages and show concepts, one who owns a production company, another who runs a large YouTube channel, one who has a Facebook page with over 4 million followers, and that was just their team. And they didn't even win this thing. So my only question next is, from this group, who's next? And what are you going to do? Let's open our time in prayer. Father God, we thank you so much for inviting us into this space this evening to celebrate creativity and the arts. We're so grateful for your beauty, Lord, and the story that you invite us to be part of. Lord, we're so grateful for the sacrifice of your Son, Jesus Christ, who makes all of this possible and worth it. Lord, may you be honored and praised tonight. Amen. Welcome to Dort University. It's great to have you.
Thank you, Brandon. Mark, I don't know about you, Mark, but after Brandon's little introduction, maybe we should consider doing this again next year, since you know, the big impact that they had.
Another 5 years.
I'm looking
years
at the team, and they're all going, "No, we're not going to do that." And it's not that we didn't enjoy the many years doing this, but there has been a lot of time put in, and things have changed. But the show, as you know, the theme is must go on, because our lives go on, the stories go on, the things we tell go on. And it's not that you're here for a show, but that those stories that you're telling, whether it's through film, writing, whatever it might be, whatever creative medium, they continue to go on. And it's been such a joy as part of this committee, I think for all of us, that we have been able to be part of those stories for the last 15 years. So for this year, we had all these ideas. We always have these ideas, different requirements that the groups have to do. And so we're going to throw up some of those on the screen here on the PowerPoint.
I'll do a little history first.
Oh, Mark wants to take some. I am so sorry I got there.
You're good.
I got so excited I didn't read that part. So Mark's going to do a little history. Sorry.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Brandon. I don't know how they got that past me. I had no idea that was going to happen. So that's going in my office, but it belongs to all of you. Thank you so much. Appreciate that. We're going to do just a really brief history of this. This is 2006. That's Mark Verbruggen, Pastor Mark Verbruggen, with a black T-shirt on, and myself in the back, and those are the DeWitt brothers. We used to do this in the next building over before we had any idea what we were doing, wearing black T-shirts, and Chris Wren was a law professor. We had a little soundboard with sliders, and he had no idea what he was doing, so he was sliding these sliders up and down. He was frustrated as all get out, and we had so much fun. And so we did that for 2 years over there, 2006 and 7, and then we thought, ah, this actually might be catching on, and then we moved it over here. And that's when I think when we brought out the skinny pants and the tuxedos. So let's jump to the next slide. I just want to, a lot of people have been asking, why? Why are you quitting after 15 years? And that's a very legitimate question. If you maybe can't see the graph well, but on the far left, it says 2006. And on the far right, that big red bar is 2022. And that's YouTube. From 2006 when we started to right now, or actually 2020. So in 2006, YouTube was just getting started. Hardly anybody knew what it was. No one was using it. Now there's billions of users, videos on YouTube. So just that alone shows that in 2006, the idea of borrowing mom and dad's camera and making a video, it was a big deal. We were doing those on tapes. You had to hand deliver it to us here in the building, and we had to then take those tapes and convert them so we could show them and all of that stuff, and we weren't shooting anything on our phones. In fact, your phones now would shoot a better film than we were doing in 2006. So just YouTube, I think, helps us understand a little bit of that, and we can jump to the next slide. So those are logos for the first 5 years or so, and you can see in 2006 is the same year that Twitter started and Facebook started in 2005. They were just getting going in 2006. Tumblr, 2007. Pinterest, Instagram, and Snapchat all started while Prayer Regress was running. And we can jump to the next one. 2013, Vine started, and I think we've outlived Vine. 2015, Periscope started. I think we've outlived Periscope. This just gives you a little idea of the changes that have happened in the last 15 years when it comes to media and film. So when we got to 2009, as a committee, we had the discussion. That was our 2015, that was our ninth year. And we said, okay, we're coming up to our 10th year. What's the future look like for us? Do we want to keep doing this? What? There was some suggestion that said, let's stop at 10 years. And as a group, we said, nope, not yet. We're not ready to stop this yet. Let's keep going. And we decided to go to 15 years. So this isn't a sudden plan. This was planned way back in year 9. So last year would have been our 15th year, but then COVID happened, so we canceled, moved it to this year. So this has been in the works for a while. We thought 15 years is a great run. Let's get off this horse while the horse is still running, rather than run it into the ground and there's no life left in it. Let's get off while we still have something good happening. So we go to our last slide. Those are our logos. TikTok started in 2017. The whole landscape has changed a lot, and we feel good about the role that we've played in this. So as Brandon pointed out, we've been able to influence a generation of young filmmakers. We've been able to help people exhibit their art. There's just something fantastic about making your film and letting a live audience see it. And there aren't a lot of opportunities for that in this part of the country, so we felt really good about doing that. You can move ahead. Or not. There we go. So, as Brandon also said, too, we feel really good about helping young filmmakers and some not young filmmakers understand that you don't have to go to the lowest common denominator to tell a good story. And we call that content worth consuming. Thank you. Content worth consuming. That's what we call it. So, I'll end our little history lesson here with a quote from Jimmy Smith. He says, "We are all storytellers. We all live in a network of stories. There isn't a stronger connection between people than storytelling." And that's really what this has been about. It's only 48 hours, but the stories that you have told over the last 15 years are amazing, especially when you consider that you had 48 hours to do it. And so this venue is coming to a close, but your stories don't have to end. Keep telling those stories. Enter other competitions. Keep honing your craft and keep enjoying content worth consuming. So I will stop our little history lesson there, and now we're going to do our theme.
Well, our storytelling this year had to include these themes as we see them on the PowerPoint. The theme is, as we said, the show must go on. The genres will be as follows: the documentaries, you could do a tragedy, you could do a musical. I don't think we saw many tragedies this year, did we, Mark, at all? It was pretty good. Yeah, no, not at all. The next one we had lines of dialogue, which have to be in the film, or at least there. Everything changed at the last curtain call. My world changed at the stoplight. I didn't see that coming, and with some of the films, we didn't see that coming, so that was entertaining. Characters, the characters we had up there, they're washed-up soap opera actor, Octavia, Dash. We had to have a person from the future. I remember a few of those coming on here, especially like there was a guy 5 minutes from the future. I remember that film as well. And there were some props, and some of the props were up there, ball yarn, mousetrap. We had... There was some very painful mouse traps I saw in one film. And Jenga and a bowling ball, which plays big in another film. So we had those categories as we go on. And each team was given at least one extra point for including the red-winged blackbird, which we don't see on the light right now, but you saw it on the side of the bill. There you go. So that was the stories for this year had to be told.
Yeah, so as we watch films today, watch for the red-winged blackbird, because there was a lot of them in there. So our normal process is we're going to watch films tonight, the best of high school, best of college, best of post-college, and the overall best of show. And that one wins the coveted Doherty Award, which is right here. This year, as a lot of you know, we added another category, the one and only time we will ever do this. We call it the winner circle. What we did was we invited all the teams over the last 14 years who won this, the coveted Doherty Award, to compete against each other for this, the Red Wing Blackbird Award. So this is called the winner circle. So we're going to show that to tonight. So because we're only going to see a few films in here tonight, we are going to do what we normally do, which is a compilation video. So A couple seconds of all the films that were shown. Oh, hashtag, yeah. Don't forget the hashtag if you're posting pictures.
What's a hashtag?
That's a hashtag there.
I'm a Luddite. I'm sorry.
Yeah, so if you see your name, your picture up here, your film, go ahead and make some noise so we know you're in the house. So let's lower the lights and watch that.
Well, it looks like you're playing tongue twister with this mister.
Fine, and we're in love, and there's nothing you can do to break us apart, not even our 17-year-old marriage.
And nothing you do will tear us apart.
Do you know why we chose to visit this time period? We wanted to see our world when it was full of life. To watch the sun go down like we'd hear about in stories. Rather than an artificial sunset.
Drink this, you'll go back in time, and you'll have a chance to change your future.
Okay.
Really? Okay? Usually people have to think it over a bit first, and have this whole speech prepared and all that.
Sounds pretty good to me.
Maximilian! What are you doing here? I think it's obvious as to why I'm here. I'm here to kill you.
To kill me?
Yes, to kill you.
Top story today is a doozy. A coffee shop was the victim of petty theft this morning. The item in question? Cash? Coffee? Surprisingly, a board game. The board game has not yet been identified. More updates will roll in as the investigation continues.
Just give me a brief introduction, your name, and why you're here.
Hey, I'm Dash Walker, and you know me from the famous soap opera, How I Met Your Mailman.
As we're flying through the blue skies of time. A wormhole.
Time suck.
A hellhole where I'm stuck with Theodora.
Ladies,
See, you're appreciating my pelts, and that just makes me feel so great. And I have a gift for you, my dear. Pule cheese.
Oh, my. That's $600 a pound.
You have any known records of possible alterations? Any sort of records of living family members that I could maybe question?
And every time he pulls a Jenga block out of the tower, it represents a part of his soul that is slowly falling away.
Hello world, coming to you live from the mess that is Sam's life, it is Ned Jones. For those just tuning in, we have witnessed another classic Sam blunder as he fumbles a simple morning conversation. Stay tuned for more. This is Ned Jones, signing off.
Detective Flynn Hunter? No one here by that name. I need your help. I'm retired. You know Octavia Taylor?
I can't find it anywhere.
Me neither, but this Hulk comic is great.
Right, you're clear. The future has not reached you yet. Take these. They will protect you.
Return to me doing the dishes, because without this pandemic, I would have a lot on my plate. But clearly my plate is empty without a job.
It's locked. He tries the second. Third, locked. Runs around the corner. The fourth and last door is open.
How do I know the tower's about to fall?
See the number? Put the number in.
I can't believe after all of this, you still don't believe me. All I want is for you to listen.
Look, I made some calls, okay? I can help you. I can get you help.
I don't need help. I need you to listen.
Have you always been this rude and snide? You know, you can be just a little less self-centered and realize that other people are struggling too. You know, the world does not revolve around you.
Yo.
Guys, I'm from the future.
Please. Your mom is.
What proof do you have?
Oh my god, I should live stream this.
Oh, yeah. Look, I have proof.
Oh yeah. I still got it.
What's he doing? He's just standing there. Let's just get over here. Hello, and sup, dudes of the 21st century.
You know what you're doing?
No. I lost my foot.
Explaining.
All right, hey, we're ready to get to the awards tonight. You know, we've been doing this for a while. We just forget as we're going through it. So, all right, we're going to get to the awards, and here is how we're going to do it. We're going to start with high school, then college, then post-college, and finally overall best of show, which receives a coveted Doherty Award. Best of show can come from any of the categories. We'll finish with the winner's circle. For high school and college and post-college, we're going to invite top two teams here based on judges' scores, assuming they are here or have a proxy, not watching on live stream. We're going to invite those teams to the front for a little chat, then we will watch a short clip from each of their films. We'll open the envelope, announce the best of the category, and at that point, the runner-up will be congratulated and can take their seats, leaving the best of the category up here with us to receive the reward, and then we'll all enjoy the winning team's film, and they could walk off with the big check.
Excellent, and this is what we're doing. This is the best of high school. They get this beautiful trophy, and each team member gets a medallion signifying the final year of the Prairie Grass Film Challenge, best of college, best of post-college, they all get that as well. The coveted Doherty Award, they also get a medallion. They're a little bit bigger. And the winner's circle gets this one-of-a-kind trophy, which will never be produced again. So that's what we're doing tonight. And before we move on, I want to have our leadership team come forward just for a few minutes. If we could get the names up there. Yeah, while they come forward, you'll notice I have two groups up on the slides there. The bottom four names are people who have been a huge part of this for many years, but because they've moved or something else, they're currently not on the leadership team, but they still are very involved. So just a few words about these people. None of them really want to be up here. You guys have to come up too. Not you yet, Miranda. We'll get to you later. Yeah, so just a few words about this. We'll start with Robert Taylor here. Robert is, these people all have full-time jobs elsewhere, and none of them get paid to do this. They do it for the love of the game. So Robert Taylor here has more than a full-time job. He is the voice of wisdom and sage advice on our team, and we have appreciated him for how many years? All 15 years. Yes, that's quite a commitment. Gail Harsma, 4 years now. Gail also works at Dort, and with Gail, if she puts something on her to-do list, it will be done. You don't have to ask twice. Detail-oriented, things like this don't function without a Gail. Vern is on the bottom list. This is unique about Vern. Vern won the very first competition in 2006. His team won. And he then went on to compete for many more years, never quite rose to those heights again. when he stopped competing, he joined the leadership team and continued to help us in that way. Last year, he moved to California and became a judge. So he's been part of this for 15 years as well. Darlene Reichert, she has the mind of a librarian, which means details are everything. And you have to have a Darlene for something like this. She's been part of this for 14 years, almost since the start. And we couldn't do it without her. Sandy Reitzma, 12, 13? It's a long time. All of the online voting tonight when People's Choice Award opens at midnight, we can thank Sandy for all of that and so many other details that couldn't do it without her. Brad Niemeyer, he used to be up on the stage here in a tux. And
he still is,
actually, in a tux. He was a pastor here at the URC here in Sioux Center. He took a call to Chino, California. He's pastoring there now. He didn't leave us, though. He kept on as a judge. And he came back to be a part of the final, and he was a judge this year as well. So we thank you for that.
He actually told me he sleeps in that.
He sleeps in that tux. Yeah. Kay DeBoom has been with us since the start, pretty close to the start, and left us just a year or two ago to pursue other things. Also, one of those people who just gets the job done. And then Bob here, of course, Bob Poma, he's a pastor here in town, and he's been on stage for, what, four years now?
Except for
COVID year. And all of these people, that award belongs to you. Thank you. This has been a fun ride. It's a little bittersweet bringing an end to this because we have a lot of fun as a team, but we will continue on as friends. So can we show them our appreciation? They each get a medallion, and I ran out of two, so we'll get two of these guys soon. Thank you, everybody.
Well, the rest of you can go down, but Robert's going to stay up here for a moment.
I don't know. One more surprise, Mark. So 15 years, It's a long time, and I would estimate that around 500 films were probably made for Prairie Grass over the years, and I'll estimate that to be around 2,500 minutes of film or 42 hours of film. And Mark has watched every single minute of every single film probably multiple times. And then Mark always headed up the committee. And I'm estimating that it's about 135 committee hours over those 15 years. And it's not just the committee hours, because the committee is where the assignments got doled out, and Mark always took the lion's share of that. So we're talking hundreds of hours that he's dedicated to all of this over the last 15 years. Mark stands for integrity. He stands for excellence, and it comes through in everything that he does. And his faith life permeates it all. And as I think about the genesis of this film challenge, I remember it's probably about 18 years ago, 17, 18, that you started talking about these things. And there was a film challenge that he had an opportunity to go and participate in, a 48-hour. And I remember he came home and he was so inspired and excited. He was dead, which you all can relate to. But he was so inspired, and he said, you know what, I think we can do this here. And so we started talking about what some of the most important aspects would be if we were going to have a film challenge here at Dort University. The first thing that he really wanted to make sure that we did was inspire the next generation of filmmakers. And I had no idea all of the examples of that were going to be given tonight. But wow, so much has transpired through the inspiration that people receive by participating in this. And I think that's amazing. The next thing that he wanted to concentrate on was, let's do something in the Midwest. Let's promote the arts in the Midwest. The coasts, lots of opportunities, New York, LA, the big metropolitan areas, lots of opportunities, but we wanted to do something here. We thought that there were stories worth telling right here in the Midwest, and that's something that Mark's always been passionate about, and giving that voice, getting those stories, those beautiful landscapes, opening it up to everyone, because we had people from all over the country and maybe some internationally even, I can't remember, but that was important. And then how does faith integrate with film and that whole content worth consuming? We've all talked about that over the years so many times. Some of the films even made fun of it over the years, but that was a phrase that Mark coined to try and help all of you filmmakers have an understanding of what we were looking for. There are lots of stories to be told, but to be a responsible filmmaker is to ask the question, who is my audience, and how should I tell my story, and what's appropriate for that audience? And I have to think, I mean, there are some children here, and there have been every year, and I have to think that there are not too many film festivals that you could confidently take a child to. I think it's so cool that that is a piece of what's been created by Mark for all these years. So Mark, we are so thankful for all the work that you've put in. And so on behalf of the president's office, on behalf of the university, on behalf of the whole team, and I think it's safe to say on behalf of all the filmmakers who have done this over the years, we just want to say thank you to you. And then we've got this as a little appreciation token for you.
Thank you very much.
Didn't expect that either. Thank you very much. Really appreciate it.
Mark, congratulations, but it's time we get to the awards tonight. We've got to move this thing along.
Yes, all right, one last slide. Our judges, those are our judges. Some of them have been introduced already. Jerry, I think, is here. Jerry, are you here? Jerry Menninga? way in the back from Sioux City. He's one of our judges, and we've got Canadians and Americans, and we're very, very grateful, and let's get to it now.
Awesome. We're going to start with the best of show in high school category. The two teams who were the most teamed points by the judges, please join us up on stage, are Sticky Tack Productions and Eagle. Sticky Tack Productions and any representative of Eagle.
Eagle Productions, are you here? If not, that's okay. You don't have to be present to win. Okay, let's watch the two little short snippets of these top two high school films.
Brown with Stoplight News reporting to you live from my kitchen. And now let's go over to Dave. We choose whether or not I impulse buy this treadmill. And well, my morning was going excellent, so I'm going to make you a lovely omelet. Breaking news, I just broke an egg. And now we cut to the story of a woman who must have been mugged. This woman is me because I cannot find a single clean mug in which to make my coffee.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of tonight's high school best of category is Sticky Tack Productions. All right, so how many years have you guys been doing the film challenge? Has it been one or two, or?
This is our first year, so, yeah.
But some of you have been in films before. Yeah, I think I remember, all right, definitely. What was the hardest part about making your film?
Editing day. Editing day. We weren't ready for editing day.
Unprepared.
Unprepared for editing day? What? How would you describe editing day in one word?
Tear-inducing.
There's a hyphen. It's, yeah.
Who cried first? Okay. That is really cool that you would admit to that. That's awesome, man. What was the best part of it, though?
I think after we got some sleep and we could watch it again once we're, you know, thinking clearly, it was good to see what we created.
Who, as we're going to see in a little bit, whose car was used for that almost skid? I thought, you know, you tried, right? That was your car?
Yeah, it was my car.
Yep.
Did your mom know that you did that?
She's aware.
Okay, all right. Good. Well, here's your award for tonight. Let's give him a hand, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations. Yep. As they go sit down, we will have a time where we will watch their winning film. Here is Spared.
So, I come to this coffee shop every day before work, but I've never seen you here before.
I know. I mean, I just started coming here.
Oh, well, the coffee's really good, right?
Yeah.
Parking lot. I do it on my way to work every day.
You don't take the road?
Oh no, this way's way faster. So, with that, and I've noticed that you have that bowling bag with you all the time. Is it special?
Can I trust you?
Of course, Roy. With anything.
It's all I have left.
All you have left of what?
Of my past. It was destroyed. There was fire everywhere. I'm trying to get back. I'm trying.
Well, what happened, Elroy?
Do you promise I can trust you?
I promise.
I'm a time traveler.
What?
You don't believe me? Of all people, I thought you would believe me!
Well, it's not that I don't believe you, it's just that... Well, time travel, Elroy, really, I mean... You and I both know that that's not possible!
Not yet, it isn't!
Look, I know you're going through a lot, but pushing me out, making up all these stories, that's not gonna make you feel better. That's not gonna fill the emptiness inside of you.
I thought I could trust you. I did trust you. I guess I was wrong.
I guess you were.
After all of this, you still don't believe me. All I want is for you to listen.
Look, I made some calls, okay? I can help you. I can get you help.
I don't need help. I need you to listen.
Next time you walk to work, take the road instead.
Thank you. never saw Elroy after that night. Maybe he went back to wherever he came from. Whatever he came from. Well, I couldn't bring myself to get rid of this. I read somewhere that every good thing must come to an end. And for Elroy and me, at the sound of the bowling ball hitting the ground, I knew it had come to an end.
All right, thank you to all of our high school teams. Cute little twist at the end there. We are ready for the best of college category. And we are going to invite two teams forward if they're both here. In random order, lights, camera, action. Are you here? Come on up. These are the top two point getters by our judges for the best of college category. So lights, camera, action, and the other team is Take Two Productions. Are you here? Come on up. You'll have to come up the center aisle because we have decorations over there. We don't want any fights, so why don't you guys stand over here? Great. Excellent. Two teams. Who's our winner this year? This is college category. And the best of show college category, the final Prairie Grass Film Challenge goes to, we need some drums, Take Two Productions. You were close. All right, we're going to watch, oh, we forgot to do that. We're going to watch the two clips a minute of these two teams. Do we even need to do that? Yeah, we want to watch those two clips a minute. Let's watch the two clips, even though we now know who won, because they're both really good.
I can't believe the producers picked Dash. Never in my entire life of directing have I had to work with such an utter talentless hack. I gotta do something about this. If I tell my career, it's ruined. Worst, the show. There's gotta be something. There's gotta be something. I gotta get rid of him. I'll kill him.
Now, I know you were gonna kill those dogs.
Where is the neurotoxin?
Detective Elroy, I don't know how you know that, but I'll never tell. All dogs must die. I will make them pay.
You heartless murderer! How could you be so cruel and unfeeling? You disgust me.
All right. It's not as bad as it looks. We'll watch the whole thing here in just a few minutes. Congratulations to Take Two Productions. So, quick question. Jonah, I know you as such a kind person. And that clip, what happened to you?
He was going to kill dogs, man. I don't know. It just happened. Tunnel vision, you know?
So, this film is kind of meta. It's a film about making a film. You'll see it in just a minute. It's very interesting. How'd you come up with this idea?
It was DJ's idea. He wasn't here to make it. He wasn't here to make it. Make it here. Words. He didn't. He's not here. And that, yeah, that. So it was his idea, and we just kind of ran with it. And what I kind of liked about it is we were kind of take all of our ideas and kind of mush them together. So we all kind of got a say in what the story was about.
We put a little red lightning bolt next to this in the program, which means it's not totally family friendly. Any comments on that? So just a warning, it's not totally family friendly. It's not bad. But if you have little kids.
If you like dogs.
Yeah. You have $250 to spend. What are you going to do with it?
Does that mean we each get like 50? We decided we were going to go out to dinner. I said if we won.
Take me along.
Yeah, you can come.
Congratulations. We'll let them sit down with all their swag, and we are going to watch that film.
Content worth consuming.
Hey guys,
I got the prompts for the Prairie Grass Film Challenge.
Yeah.
Okay, so in the required elements, it has the character a time traveler. That's kind of cliche, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, it is what it is. The person thinks he or she is from the future. Male is Elroy, female Theodora. Prop is Jenga.
Jenga.
And the line of dialogue is, I didn't see that coming. And then the required genre is like, basically like he's got all these genres, so it could be any genre.
I actually think I have Jenga.
Oh, nice. So does anyone have any ideas?
I got an idea. Time traveler was mad that he lost a game of Jenga, so he went back in time to a 6-year-old game and still ended up losing.
That's an idea. Mm-hmm. Okay, so what if there's this guy who invents like an imaginary friend in his virtual reality headset, and his imaginary friend
that doesn't sound like a good idea. It'll never win.
Hold that thought.
Think about it. Every year, the film that wins is always deep and meaningful, right? So, we start with our lead, Elroy, who can be wrestling with hardships in his life.
And every time he pulls a Jenga block out of the tower, it represents a part of his soul that is slowly falling away. So the film is like an exploration of the human soul and how it perceives time and emotion.
Wait, stop. Haven't you ever taken advanced film video production with Professor Mark Volkers? Remember the thumb? The number one rule of filmmaking is don't be boring.
But there's a difference between being boring and being meaningful, you know?
I don't care. I think we should do something more exciting, like something with action or comedy. I'm sure mockumentary's on there. We could do something like The Office, and I could be your roommate or something.
Oh.
Now that
I did not see that coming.
I'm doing yoga, bro. Get out of here, Elroy. What type of name is Elroy anyway? God.
Last time I walked in on him, he said he was doing calisthenics. I don't think you need a fish tank to do calisthenics.
Ever since I've been doing sports again, my knees, my arms, they've just been sore, and I found that yoga's really a good way to relieve that stress. I've also been doing a lot of ab workouts. You see my abs?
I walked in on him once, and he said he was doing strength training. He had 5 piñatas. 5. Okay, well, I didn't want to see you birthing on the floor anyway. And then I, being a time traveler, go back in time so I don't have to see
that. Okay, hold on. Does that really sound like content worth consuming? I mean, you don't even have Jenga in there.
We can just have Jenga in the background.
But that's not the point. Jenga is supposed to be the central point. That's what the judges want.
I don't care what the judges want. I'm looking out for the people. The people don't want some philosophical bullcrap.
Okay, so we'll do less philosophy and less comedy and more action. I have an idea. Now, I know you were gonna kill those dogs. Where is the neurotoxin?
Detective Elroy, I don't know how you know that, but I'll never tell. All dogs must die. I will make them pay.
You heartless murderer! How could you be so cruel and unfeeling? You disgust me.
Why are you making me out to be so cold and heartless? Why can't I be the hero and you be the villain? How could you be so cold and heartless?
Okay, fine, but I'm not gonna let you interrogate me.
Guys, stop fighting. This is our last paragraph. We need to make it count.
All right, guys. Here's my idea. Let's just make our movie for the Paragraphs Film Challenge about us making our movie for the Paragraphs Film Challenge.
Doing a movie for the Paragraphs Film Challenge about us making a movie
for the
Paragraphs Film Challenge?
The last one.
For the last one?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, yeah. I'm done with that.
I like it.
Sounds legit.
This is why we're not judges. We would never pick a film that pokes fun at us. But our judges loved it. Good job, team.
We move on to our post-college group as though the best of show of post-college. Now we want to have those teams come on up. Those teams are Kalta. Kalta Productions. And if I say this right, Saboy Films or Saber Films. Saber Films. Excuse my... Kalta, if you have you guys go over here, please. Yep. And Saber Films. All right. We're going to watch 2 clips from each of those films at this time.
I molded myself into the best news anchor possible by trial and tribulation. This took years of experience to attain this level of greatness. I started out as a war journalist. The battlefield hardened me and built my sense of patriotism. I've covered scenes of turmoil, from natural disasters as an on-the-field reporter. And we don't have any pictures of this, but I have saved babies from burning buildings. That's just a fact.
I just wish I'd bowled more when I was younger.
Oh? I can actually help you out with that.
Yeah, I've asked for the bumpers, and it just makes things worse.
No. Have you heard about the barista's choice?
Yeah, but I'm pretty happy with my usual.
No. The barista's choice is not a normal coffee. It's a time travel coffee.
What?
Okay, you said you wanted to go back in time, right? I'm a barista, I make coffee, I send people back in time. It's kind of my gig here.
Our best of show this year, our final year for post-college is Culta Studios. So how many times have you guys been to the Prairie Grass Film Festival?
This is my seventh year.
Okay. Have you ever won Best of Show or anything like that before?
We've won Best of College.
Best of College?
Three.
And now you're past college.
Oh, Best of College.
Okay, all right, okay. I just wanted to remind you, you've graduated, yeah, right? Yeah. And what school are you guys from? Or were from?
SDSU and Augie.
All right, you're my man. All right. What's the best part of making a film together?
I mean, it's letting everyone's talents come out. I mean, we have so many talented people with music, editing, videography, everything. Everyone's so talented, and it's so fun to see everyone explore that.
What would be your best advice for people making short films today?
Get your idea first, quickly, so you have enough time to actually get the idea out.
And then start filming.
Yeah. Order matters.
Did anybody start filming before they had their idea? Okay, control. All right. Let's give them a hand, ladies and gentlemen. Any other things that you'd like us to know about Culta Studios before we watch your film? So I would say see you again next year, but hey. All right, we're going to watch your film. Give them a hand as they go down, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much.
What's wrong?
I wish I was good at bowling.
I don't know what you want me to say here, man.
There's an annual bowling party at work, and every year I come in last place and embarrass myself, and everyone makes fun of me.
Sorry to hear that.
I just wish I'd bowled more when I was younger.
Oh? I can actually help you out with that.
Yeah, I've asked for the bumpers, and it just makes things worse.
No. Have you heard about the barista's choice?
Yeah, but I'm pretty happy with my usual.
No. The barista's choice is not a normal coffee. It's a time travel coffee.
What?
Okay, you said you wanted to go back in time, right? I'm a barista. I make coffee. I send people back in time. It's kind of my gig here. Okay. Drink this. You'll go back in time, and you'll have a chance to change your future.
Okay.
Really? Okay? Usually people have to think it over a bit first and have this whole speech prepared and all that.
Sounds pretty good to me.
Okay. How do you feel?
I don't feel anything. Did it work? Elroy, I'm from the future. You need to start bowling. I'm really sorry. I already messed that up. Can I get a retry?
Yeah, that was pretty bad. Okay, that one is on the house, but you only get 3 more tries, okay? Here you go.
Can I get another?
All right. Take a drink.
Hey! Hey!
Oh my God, are you okay?
No, I'm not.
Do you need me to call an ambulance or something?
No, I need you to start bowling.
Hey, no, I don't have any money. I'm sorry.
No, seriously. All the cool kids are bowling.
Hey, if you follow me, I will call the police.
Yeah, that was a bit rough. Maybe consider being a bit more subtle next time.
Sure. Subtle. Give me another one. I had the craziest night last night. I couldn't keep the ladies off me. I was at the bowling alley, bowling strike after strike. I could barely get back to my seat. The ladies were trying to smooch me so much. I'm telling you, man, that's what the women want. A competent bowl.
That was, better.
What am I supposed to say to him?
He's you. You know you better than anyone. What would it take you to want to go bowling?
I think I have it. Take me back to finals week, senior year, right after the chemistry exam.
One finals week. Come in, right up.
You peed your pants in the third grade to get out of running the mile. You're afraid of rope because it reminds you of snakes, and you just bombed that chemistry final.
I did?
Give it a second.
What are you, like me from the future or something?
Yes. I also know you wanted to try out for the middle school play, but you were too scared. You wanted to ask Sarah out every day of freshman year, and if you had, you'd be married. I have the same regrets when I look back at where you are now. Elroy,
There's one thing you could do that would fix all our problems. You need to start bowling.
Bowling?
I can't tell you why. Just know that it's the single most important thing you could ever do.
Okay.
I really thought that would take more convincing.
Should I start now?
I guess so.
Well done.
Did it work?
See for yourself.
I did it. I can finally go back to my life and be respected at work.
Not so fast, my guy. You can't go back to your old timeline. That's reserved for the other L right now.
I didn't see that coming. What am I supposed to do?
Now you get to stay here.
You run the shop now?
Thanks, my guy.
What do you need, my guy?
Thank you, post-college teams, for competing. Two awards left. We have the coveted Doherty Award and the Winner's Circle Award, and we're ready to go to this one now. And for this, we're not doing the top two point getters. We're just going to go straight to the winner. So, Bob, let's find out who it is. We should have a little drum beating, don't you think, for this one? All right. The coveted Doherty Award for the final Prairie Grass Film Children goes to Montenay Productions. And this is a musical. Montenay, I don't think they're here. They are from New York. So we are going to see if we can call them. Hi, who's this?
This is Kyle and Shannon. Our live stream must be way behind because we don't. What's going on?
You just won. Okay, Kyle, can you hear us okay?
We can hear you great.
Tell us where you are right now.
We are in upstate New York, and Shannon is here. She is 9 months pregnant, so we could have been at the hospital right now, but we are at home.
When is Shannon due?
Valentine's Day.
Last Monday.
Last Monday. So we have an idea for you. Maybe you could name your kid the coveted Doherty.
Yes, we already planned on it.
I already planned at it. Okay, what do we ask people in New York? What are you going to do with your money? Give it to the kid now. Put it in a college fund so they can come to Dort?
Yeah, we're going to buy diapers.
Okay. Diapers. Yeah, so you won the Doherty Award for your film, Montenay. It is a musical. You have, is it what, three original songs in there?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
And what?
Yeah, we wrote...
I'm sorry, what prompted you to decide to do a musical? That's tough in 48 hours.
I
thought it would always be really funny and, like, really fun to try, but it was too scary. But now it was our last one. So we had to.
Well, the judges liked your work, so they are awarding you the coveted Doherty, and we will send you your stuff next week We are going to watch the film. Anything you want to tell us about it before we let you go and have a baby?
We wrote it together. I just wanted to say that, you know, Prairie Grass has been such a huge part of our lives, and we're so grateful to you, Mr. Volkers, and to the whole team that puts it together, because it's just such a wonder, such a great time every year. So thank you.
Well, thank you for competing, and congratulations to you both.
Let us watch Monte Ney.
Theodora.
Elroy.
Theodora.
Where the hell, Roy, did we go up?
I don't know, dear Theodora, but I guess you think it's my fault.
I didn't say it's your fault.
You always say it's my fault.
I didn't say it's your fault.
I'm saying what you're thinking, and now we're both sinking through time. A time warp.
I hate this. Oh, why'd I go and date this?
I'm Elroy.
I'm Theodora. He's Elroy.
She's Theodora. You broke my ukulele. I'd had it since a baby. I told you not to touch it. You had to go and touch it. The next thing that I realized, we're flying through the blue skies of time. A wormhole.
Time suck.
A hellhole where I'm stuck with Theodora.
Whoa, where the crap are we?
Wait a minute, I know this place. This was my house.
Really? How many houses do you have?
Not like now, like back when I was a kid. When I was that kid. That's me, when I was a baby.
Oh my gosh, look at you. You're actually so cute. Huh. Go say hi.
Why don't you go? You can make him feel insecure about himself.
Just go.
Hey there, bud. Look, I know that not everything works out quite the way you hope it does, but you've got a lot going for you. Don't be a jerk. Take care.
That's it?
Yeah, chaos theory and all that. We gotta figure out how to get out of here.
Yeah. Okay, this all happened when the ukulele broke.
When you broke my ukulele.
Okay, well, it's always hanging off the stupid table.
It's been on that same table for years.
Okay, is the ukulele here?
Yeah, it's my dad's ukulele. Of course it's here.
It's your dad's?
So what, you think if we just touch it, it'll take us back home?
Yeah, maybe. Worth a shot. Are you sure that's you?
Elroy.
Oh, crap. Let's go. Go, go, go.
Duh. Hey, buddy. How's it going? What you reading there? Oh my goodness. That's my favorite. You know what else I love? Flying! Wow!
Holy cow! Dad!
That's your dad.
You ready to go?
He looks just like you.
What? No.
Put on your favorite jammies, read you a bedtime story. How does that sound, huh?
It's kind of nice.
What?
It's kind of nice. Just hanging out.
Yeah, I guess. We gotta get that ukulele. I think it's upstairs. Come on.
Is that a mousetrap?
What? Oh. Yeah. He's a single dad. Cut him some slack. I turn out fine, okay? Come on.
I slow time down to a fraction. Every time you smiled and made it bright. And if I had a time device, I'd live every moment twice. Small mundane up to the paradise. But I don't have
I think we're clear. Team.
So until then, it's you and me.
That's really sweet. You used to sing that to me.
What? I'm gonna go and see if I can touch the ukulele or whatever. You stay here.
You used to sing me that song when I was sad. Crank a tiny music box you built by hand. And you'd snuggle in and wouldn't leave till 5. And you lied to your boss about your night. You would sing me that song and we'd laugh about my day. I would prattle and I'd babble, but you said that was okay. On the corner of Highway 10 and Main, there's a stoplight where I'd call you every day. As I turned there, we'd talk the drive away. On the corner of Highway 10 and Main, you would sing me that song and you'd ask about my day. I would prattle and I'd babble and I thought it was okay. Until I stopped, 'cause you didn't seem to care. I was too much, and I guess that's probably fair. My world changed at the stoplight that day.
I didn't know you felt like that.
I just miss you.
I miss you too. Found the ukulele.
And nothing happened?
I don't think that's why we were meant to come back.
If I had a time machine, I'd go back when you and me were perfect and everything was right. If I had a time contraption, I'd slow time down to a fraction every time you smiled and made it bright. If I had a time device, I'd live every moment twice, the small mundane up to the paramount. But I don't have a time machine, so until then, it's you and me, and every fleeting moment, make it count.
Ready to go home?
Yeah.
Me too.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we enter the winner's circle part of the competition, we are going to show you a short retrospective of the previous winners of the coveted Doherty Award. Not all films we were able to be on this video, but these are a sample of some of the winners over the years. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we now come to the time where we will announce the winner of the winner's circle, and they will receive the one-time award of the Blackbird Award. Blackbird Award, is that what we call it? Yes. All right, here we go. And the winner is this year. Who will it be? Think of It Productions. Come on up. Sure, go ahead.
As they're coming up, this is a team that you didn't see their name up on the big screen because they are actually a split between a team that has won. And they asked us, come on up, guys. They asked us weeks before the competition if they could make two teams out of their one, and our leadership team agreed to that. So that's why you haven't seen their name up there. But many of the members here have been on a winning team before.
So what kind of questions should I ask your team today? What was the best part of making this film?
Yeah, I think my favorite part is, this is my eighth Prairiegrass film, and I'm usually the actor. So this year was kind of more of a team lead. And as an actor, my favorite part is when I'm done and I watch everyone else do the work. So this year it was a little different experience, but it's always fun to see it come together, I think. Like our first viewing as a team is probably my favorite part of every year.
What was the biggest challenge?
Yeah, I think like this year, sort of creating the team, there was a little bit of work I could have done as a team leader, I think, to maybe make sure everybody was on the same page. So we kind of had, you know, our first night, we had to kind of get all on the same page. So I'm very glad and, yeah, very proud of the work we did. So
how was it coming up with the mousetrap, right?
Yes, so we got a mousetrap prop, and I was actually thinking with all the time traveling, one of our ideas that we didn't do did involve time travel, so that was a little, glad we didn't pick that one, because that would have been awkward with all the other time travel ones.
Anybody injured by the...
It didn't really hurt that bad.
Trooper.
Any advice for any young filmmakers from any of you?
Yeah, pick a good team and work with your friends because it's just that much more fun when you can be around people that you love for an entire weekend.
Will they remain your friend?
I hope so. That's the goal, yeah.
Well, let's give them a hand, ladies and gentlemen. And we'll now watch their film.
Welcome back, everybody. This is still Ned Rowe with Never Not Ned Rowe News. Today, we've got a story fresh out of the oven for you. Let's turn it over to Janice for more news.
Ned, Janice is on leave.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was misinformed. We can cut this, right?
No, we're live.
Of course we are, because I'm Ned Rowe, and I'm never not on the air. Well, to make a long story short, an unpronounced man of courage saved a woman from impending doom this morning as she fumbled into the street. Statements from the scene record our hero as saying, quote, "This experience has been life-altering. My world changed at the stoplight." All right, that's all for now. So remember, stay slick, never be thick, because there's always more news to hear.
Okay, this is our denouement. We are about done. Refreshments, wonderful refreshments await us in the back. But before we go, we have one last treat, a surprise. There's been a team that's been competing for 11 years now. They've gotten very close to winning, but they've never won anything. But they have always made us and our judges laugh. You know how sometimes when you laugh, you can have a big belly laugh? Sometimes you just sort of do the nose thing. You got to like that. You call it a snort, right? So for one and one time only, instead of a Doherty Award, we're going to give away a Snorty Award. It's quite beautiful. There's a team from Sioux Falls that always makes us laugh. And their name is Udo Velvet. We'd love for them to come up here to receive a Snorty Award. Udo Velvet, they almost always poke fun at us, or at content worth consuming, or at the smell of cows and pigs in Sioux Center, or something like that. They just one time, okay, one time. But we've had so much fun with them, and they've been such good competitors, and they've gotten close, and we want to present to them the Snorty Award. Let me just read it out loud here a minute before you hand it over. Prairie Grass Film Challenge presents the Snorty. Prairie Grass Film Challenge 2022 presented to Udo Velvet for always making us laugh. Give him a hand. So it might be a little bit dangerous to give people like this the mic, but is there anything you want to say for our final?
Make sure it's content worth consuming.
Anything you guys want to say about your process or anything?
Probably the thing I would say is I read the first time we did this, do what you do. I mean, don't change what you do to fit into whatever. So we just kind of do, this is kind of what we've always done. So we've done that. And we did win post-college in 2013.
Oh, did you?
Yes, so I guess we have to give this back then. So.
Yeah, give it back. No, that's great. Congratulations. We're going to watch their film, and then we're going to have refreshments. So thank you all very much. So, yeah, we're going to watch your film.
Give them a hand, ladies and gentlemen.
I was told to hand out some stickers.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Okay, we're going to watch that film, and then we will just have a couple things, and we're done.
They used to laugh at me. They said I was a fool for loving you. Well, tonight, I will have my revenge, my darling. Tonight and forever! Well, maybe tonight's enough.
Yes? I'm Robert Wellington. Oh, the butler. Yes. Well, I don't want to know your name. I'm paying you good money, and I just want to call you the butler. You're the help. You're the butler.
What am I to do?
You stand there. When a person arrives, you announce the name clearly so I can understand it and prepare for their arrival. You are not to leave this spot.
What if I have to go to the bathroom?
Did you see my neighbor with the swing set in the front yard?
Yes.
A, I detest them. B, they got bushes. C, you gotta go to the bathroom. And E, you figure it out. We have a guest!
Introducing Angelo Kedicke and his boy.
He's not my boy.
And his boy, Elroy.
You know, 5 minutes ago, I knew you were going to look out that window.
Angelo, the invite wasn't for plus one.
Yes, but he's such an interesting plus one, don't you think? Look, guess where he's from.
Prison!
No. The future. 5 minutes in the future, to be precise. Isn't he fascinating? I mean, he's a little weird otherwise, but fascinating.
Hello.
Don't tell anyone where he's from. I want it to be a surprise.
He's useless. Angelo, look, I made you one of my muffins that you love. Sadly, I have nothing for you.
If I were you, I'd go to the bathroom. 5 minutes.
Mother! Oh, mother!
Who makes one muffin?
Oopsie.
What a weirdo.
We have a visitor! Announcing Mr. Gardener.
No, man, I'm the gardener. You gonna walk me in?
No, I was told not to move. Go.
Sir, I was thinking we should plant some bulbs along the front walk, maybe.
Oh, yeah, that'd be a good idea. I can see you around to do that.
Well, yeah, it's only a couple months away.
Oh, it's only a couple months? Yeah, that's right. I can envision you doing it right now. I can envision you in the dirt. Here, I bought you some gardening gloves, special for you, because you're the gardener. And give me this.
Gee, thanks.
Yeah, go enjoy the party.
Look what the boss gave me.
No, it's okay. He's from the future.
Does he realize a whooping he's going to get in the future?
Oh, no, don't. Just let him have them. Let's see what he does.
He's a rabbit. He's a rabbit. He's a rabbit.
Hey, this party's really going to be jumping. It's getting dark out, man.
Theodora Leisensnors and Wilhelmina Wolt. I'm introducing them.
The sisters.
What a ghastly party.
Reminds me of your fourth wedding. Or was it your fifth?
Eh.
Ladies, see, you're appreciating my pelts, and that just makes me feel so great. And I have a gift for you, my dear. Pule cheese.
Oh, my. That's $600 a pound.
It is, exactly. And that sort of explains the...
The Ritz crackers.
Yes. And I have something for you, Theodora, my dear.
Well, I should hope so.
That English tea you love so much, PG Tips.
Oh, my. That's $3.49 at the Shop and Save.
It is, but you do enjoy it so, my dear.
Not anymore. The doctor says that cheap tea gives me the winds.
Okay, ladies, I'll be right back. You just enjoy that tea and sniff that cheese.
Plop. Plop. Plop.
You, sir, are a cad. And you know just what it takes to capture my heart and wrap it up in a veil of lust and regret.
I didn't see that coming.
What do you mean?
You used that line on your fourth husband.
And I fell for it, too.
Angelo! I should have known you'd be here.
Hey, everybody. I'm going to the shed to get some shovels, because it's a party, right?
You want me to go with you?
No, no, man. You go and sit and mingle. It's a party, right? Why isn't everybody mingling? Come on, mingle. Come on, get up, get up. Come on, go around. Yeah, round, around. Yeah, get that circulation pumping. Get that heart going. Oh, smell that cheese. Smell that cheese, woman. All right, I'll be right back.
This party's dead.
What? You're alive? You're alive? How can that be? I poisoned all of you.
Poisoned? Why?
Why, Theodora? Why? Because one of you took the only thing I loved in this world.
Velcro?
No, Tabitha, my red-winged blackbird. I came down last week, and I found her laying in the bottom of my cage. Bottom of my cage!
That bird was like 15 years old.
And that's longer than you're gonna live.
That doesn't... Dude, how old do you think I am?
15-year-old boy! So I've invited you all to this party, and you fell for this mousetrap that I've set. I've made this visual aid. I was gonna make one for all of you, but I ran out of time.
That would have been a nice touch.
Okay, listen, y'all gonna be dead soon, so if you could just do me a favor and just lay down on this top that I provided to you.
Not so fast.
Oh, hey, I forgot about you. I'll give you your $20 and you can go home.
I'm Detective Wellington. I got a call from L. Ron Hubbard.
I go by Elroy now.
He said there were going to be murders here.
Elroy saved our lives.
But you never gave me food. How would you poison me?
Very simple. The fingers got little poison pricks in them. You take your hand, you put it inside.
You have 5 minutes to get to the hospital.
It's bye-bye birdie time for you.
No, wait a second. Because I got something to say. The last 15 years, once a night in January, we would get together on a frigid night. And we would make content worth consuming. Or at least we believed we did. And I grew to fall in love with this team and bond with this team. And I just want to let you know that I...
That was not 5 minutes.
You actually believe I'm from the future?
Gentlemen, we're drawing to the end of our time together tonight. We want to thank you for the films and the laughter and the enjoyment and the drama that we saw, the stories that you were writing. Thank you so much. Don't forget that we have a People's Choice Award up on the screen. People's Choice opens at midnight tonight at the pgfc.film. So please vote so we can give a People's Choice. But thank you for coming tonight and for your time here. Mark?
Yep, and we want to give thanks to these organizations for supporting us so faithfully for so many years and helping us out. Want to give a special shout-out to Daniel Ketchelos. If you enjoyed all of our digital assets up on the screens, the counters and everything else, that is Daniel's work. And Miranda Munson was our show producer this year. She is in charge of making this all work. Thank you, Miranda. We're grateful for you. And is that it?
That's it. It's about it. But I think we want to end on a high note tonight before we go and have catered snacks. Weren't we supposed to talk about that?
Yes. Go ahead.
Actually, we'd like them to leave and we could keep this. I'm joking.
There we go.
At our 5th anniversary and our 10th, we dropped balloons. But for our 15th, we're doing something different. So before we go, for our catered refreshments in the back, as we said, we want to end properly, not with balloons, but with streamers, to celebrate a wonderful conclusion to a wonderful event. So everybody on your feet. And we're gonna count down from 5. Ready? On your set, get ready, get set.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And when you're all done looking at streamers, feel free to enjoy some refreshments in the back. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Knight. Have a good night, ladies and gentlemen.